Ad extensions allow us to make our ad copy a lot more appealing to the user because we can add additional information to our ad copy in the Google results page. The first kind of ad extensions that we got quite a long time ago were site links, and we have a video that walks through a number of different strategies for site links that you can check out right here. But there are also different options like structured snippets, callouts, price extensions. And the thing that all of these have in common is that they're all text-based. They're all just additional words on the Google results page. So today I want to talk about image ad extensions. They're one of the newer types of ad extensions that we have in Google, and they allow you to attach an image to your ad in the results page. I'm going to go through a couple of examples and show you the timeline of what ad extensions have looked like in the past, and then show you how you can get started with them in your campaigns. Here are a couple quick examples of what an image ad extension can look like. They're both going to be on mobile. This is where it's going to show up the most. But you can see here that on a mobile device, it is a little bit more appealing to have either a picture with a bright yellow background of those noise-canceling headphones, or an image of a model wearing some of the clothes from Hugo Boss. So obviously this makes it a little bit more appealing, more visually stimulating when you're looking for something on Google. As I mentioned, these extensions have been around for a while, even if they are one of the newer options. So just wanted to show a quick history in case you've heard of these before. This is a nice little timeline that somebody on the internet has put together. I've seen this image a bunch of different places, so I'm sorry I can't attribute it properly. But they first came out around 2016. You could see some of the options that we had here. And then it slowly evolved to the point where we see now, going back to that same noise-canceling headphones that I just showed you a second ago. So now that you have an example of what these look like, let's hop into the interface and start setting them up. No matter where you are in the Google Ads interface, these image ad extensions are going to live in the Ads and Extensions section. So let's just come over here to Ads and Extensions, open it up, and then we'll come down to Extensions. Once you're on this tab, there is a card for image extensions that'll basically allow you to go in and see which image extensions are already in place and give you a pretty quick preview. For the sake of editing this video, because we don't have anything there and I don't want to make us have to blur things out, I'm not going to scroll down, but just trust me, there's an image ad extension version down there. So to get started creating our first image ad extension, I'm just going to click this blue plus button and come down to image extension. Image extensions can only be added at the campaign or ad group level. They cannot be applied at the account level like some other ad extensions can. So when I came into the extensions section of the interface, I wasn't already opted into a campaign. So the first thing I need to do here is choose which campaign I'm going to apply this to. You can apply it to all, a select handful, or just one campaign. So for right now, I'm just going to click one and move forward. If you decide at another point that you want to add your image ad extensions at the ad group level, you simply need to come over here, choose the add to section. You can choose from the dropdown that you want to choose ad group, and then you'll see a prompt that is similar to what we just went through, where it'll have you choose the campaign and the ad group or ad groups that you want to apply the image ad extension to. For now, we'll just leave it at the campaign level. Since there are no image ad extensions eligible in this account, we're going to go ahead and just create a new one from scratch. And then in a minute, I'll show you what it looks like when you get to use an existing one. The first thing to know when getting started with image ad extensions is that they must meet quality standards of Google Ads. You cannot use a logo overlay, text overlay. You can't use GIFs, and blurry or poorly cropped images aren't allowed. So Google is trying to retain a high quality of image for these ad extensions. So if you're getting started with these and you don't have a high quality image, probably save yourself a little bit of time. Go find a high quality image that doesn't have a logo or text overlay before you even get started. For now, I'm going to click Add Images, and you'll see that this looks similar to what it looks like when you add assets to a responsive display ad, which we've talked about on this platform before. There are a few different ways that you can add images to this. The first is going to be upload. The second that I really like is going to be scan website. So I'm just going to do an example of this scan website really quick to show you how it works. All you need to do is add in your website URL. And once I clicked enter, it scanned the website, and now it's showing me a select number of images that I could use for image ad extensions. You can see that if I hover over it, I can just click use image. It'll then open up an editor to allow me to choose which areas I want for a 1-to-1 and a 1.91-to-1 ratio. These are going to be the two different ratios you choose for image ad extensions, and they'll show up in different placements. That's why you can use both. So let's say that I liked this right away. So I would go ahead and just click select two ratios. If I wanted to add a second image, I could come to this one. I could say use image. And just for example, let's say that this second ratio didn't look right for me. All you have to do is come in here and click the X when you hover over it. And now you're only utilizing one ratio, and you would then come down and click select ratio to add to the campaign. One of the reasons I really like the scan website portion is because Google's only going to pull in the images that you are allowed to use and that it thinks will be relevant. But on top of that, it also chooses to pull in any of the information that you have from your Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, or LinkedIn profiles. This is really great if you don't have lots of images on your website, but you have been really diligent and successful loading in a lot of different images on your social media platforms. You can utilize those as well. You don't have to use only the images from your website. You'll see now that I added in these couple of different images here, this Your Assets section has changed. So if I click in here, you'll see that I now have 3 out of 20 eligible images for these image ad extensions. And it's got the 2 Facebook options that I have and the 1 Google Ads, and it's got the right ratios shown so you can tell which ones are in the square versus which ones are in the landscape portion. Heading back over into the most common way to get images into the image ad extension is simply to upload files that you want from your computer. By now, you probably know how to upload images to Google Ads, so I'm not going to show you how to do that. But rather, I do want to kind of expand a little bit on the requirements for image ad extensions. So we already talked about it a little bit while I was going through the scan website portion. But effectively, you can have 2 different sizes of images for image ad extension. You can have the landscape, which is that 1.91-to-1 ratio, or more commonly known as the 1200 by 628. If you've run ads on social platforms, your ears probably just perked up because that means you can use all of the ads that you have been creating for those social platforms right here as image ad extensions. You'll just need to take out any of the text or logo overlays to make them eligible. The minimum for that size is going to be 600 by 314. You can also use square, which is just a 1-to-1 or again 1200 by 1200 image ad size, which can also be utilized on a lot of the social platforms. The good news about these image ad extensions is that the dimensions are not complex. If anything, your design team is going to be very thankful that they are effectively the exact same as what you would use on most of the other platforms around the web. After that, the file size just needs to be a maximum of 5120 kilobytes, and then everything else just needs to follow those quality standards that we talked about earlier. Once you have all of the image ad extensions that you want, all you need to do is click save, and you'll see that they populate over here off to the left. And again, you can still see that some of them are square, some are landscape, but this just gives you a really good visual of what you have here. Once you're ready to apply these to your campaigns, all you have to do is click save. For now, I'm not going to do that because image ad extensions are not eligible in all accounts, and quite frankly, the images I'm using here make absolutely no sense with the business that's being advertised because I had to use an account that had them. So instead, let's hop into an account that's had them in place for a short period of time, and I'll show you what the reporting looks like. Okay, now we can see the card that shows what it would look like when you have image ad extensions in place. So as you can see here, we've got the preview off to the left. There are lots of images in the middle, and then there's a little bit of a recommendation off to the right. I'm sorry most of this is blurred out, but you really don't need to see who this is. But you can get a sense for what it looks like when you come in here to an account that has image ad extensions applied. You'll then see that we do have a high level set of stats up here at the top, and they're very low impressions because we just added these to the campaign. But if we want to see a little bit more insight into performance, we just click on image. And now it'll bring up a much larger table of data that shows everything from impressions, clicks, cost, conversion, conversion rate, and you can see a lot more information in here. These are specifically applied to ad groups, so it will show what level things are applied to. You can see that they're applied to the ad group level, but then you can also see the specific ad group that they're applied to in the added to section. If they were applied to the campaign level, that would just reflect the campaign name that's in place. You can also see that one of these is disapproved for text or a logo overlay in the image. Quite frankly, this does not have a text or logo overlay in the image. It's just a picture of the product, and the product itself has text on it, and it also has a logo of the company that makes that product. So keep in mind that Google will be sensitive to the image you utilize, because if your product itself has your logo or text or something like that, it could be disapproved and you'll have to go argue it in the policy manager and try and get another review of the image ad extension that you've applied. To circle back earlier, the last thing I mentioned is that I wanted to show you how to apply an image ad extension from an existing library. So let's come up here and click the blue plus button again. Last time in that other account, we just went through and we created new, but let's choose use existing. When I did that, you can now see that there are 19 image ad extensions eligible here. And all I have to do is check the box next to any of the individual ones that I want. Let's say I just want these three, and then I can easily have those added to the campaign by clicking save. Image ad extensions are probably some of the easiest extensions to set up aside from callouts and structured snippets. The biggest area you need to focus on is the image quality and the aspect ratios. Make sure that whatever images you're utilizing ideally can be used in either a square or landscape format, or that you have different versions of that image in those formats that you can use, maybe with different placement of the product, maybe with different backgrounds, all of that good stuff. And they need to make sure that they don't have any sort of text or logo overlay and that the quality of the image is high. Because even in some of these examples that we're seeing in the ad preview, you can kind of tell that the images are not very big. So just like we discussed the Google responsive display ads needing to be singularly focused, these are going to be the same way. Make sure that these pictures aren't cluttered. There's not a bunch of extra background and extra noise. You want them to be eye-catching and appealing to your target audience, so they'll click on them, come to your website, and ideally make a purchase. When somebody clicks on an image ad extension, it's going to be treated exactly like a headline. You'll notice that all through this setup, there's no destination URL, there's no additional text, anything like that. So anytime somebody clicks on that image, it's exactly the same as clicking on the headline of the ad. They're going to go to the landing page of the main ad, and all of the text they've seen is just the ad that surrounds it. And that's it. Overall, image ad extensions are pretty easy. They don't take a lot of setup. Just got to make sure you have the right images, but you can apply them to campaign or ad group levels to make sure that your ads look as visually appealing as possible in the search engine results.
Thanks for watching our video. If you thought it was useful, give us a thumbs up below.
We release a new video at least once a week, so if you want to get notified of when a new one comes out, be sure to subscribe to the Paid Media Pros channel.